Ouspensky was a Russian philosopher, mathematician and mystic whose various interests carried him towards the study of esoteric. Abandoning formal education system, he started oriental trips to East, visiting various occult schools in search of what he calls miraculous. His quest brought him in contact with Gurdjieff, who seemed to have answers to many of his questions. Ouspensky addressed problems before philosophy, metaphysics, and science of his time by providing logical insights into concepts of space and time, higher dimensions, idea of esotericism, eternal recurrence, and fourth wave. For Ouspensky, the idea of fourth dimension or higher dimensions in general is the key to all mysteries in the universe. He considered time as illusion and comprehended it in spatial sense. According to him, actual reality can be perceived by studying higher dimensions of space. Here laws of phenomenal world are not valid. Ouspensky used subjective methods to analyze his concepts. He advocated use of psychological methods to study phenomena in the world. Ouspensky systematized his philosophy in two major books. One is Tertium Organum and the other is A New Model of Universe. Tertium Organum is a classic thought-provoking book on logic and epistemology, which he declared as third canon of thought, a key to enigmas of the world. Through this book, he argued that a new mode of thinking was needed in Western civilization. Before Ouspensky, two modes of logic, that is, first one was Aristotle's Organon, that was considered the first book of logic, and the second one is the Francis Bacon, he wrote a new Organon. After them, Ouspensky's was the Tertium Organum, that is the third canon of thought. Ouspensky's Tertium Organum brought together theories of Eastern and Western mysticism, as well as sacred art and modern science, in a way that enlightened and moved the seeker towards a higher consciousness and greater understanding of the principle of the universe. He himself said that I have called this system of higher knowledge Tertium Organum because for us it is this third canon of thought after Aristotle and Bacon. First was Organon, second was Novum, but the third existed earlier than the first. Here Ouspensky is referring to the ancient system of thought while he is referring that third existed earlier than the first. Ouspensky's philosophy is influenced by many thinkers like Plotinus, Kant, Nietzsche, and Gurdjieff. He quotes many classical philosophers, mystical thinkers of West and East. In particular, Plotinus' treatise on intelligible beauty is cited as the most precise formulation of his system of higher logic. Theosophist writers also influenced his thought. Further scientific theories of that time, especially the work of N.A. Ohmov and Minkowski, strongly influenced his philosophy of higher dimensions. Systematizing his philosophy, Ouspensky argued that world exists, or at least appears to us as existing in space and time, where space is three-dimensional. He developed Kant's idea of space and time as being the mental constructs, and C.H. Hinton's idea of four dimensions of space. Kant argued that space and time are conceptual properties of our mind, not of objective world, so the reality in itself cannot be known. If Kant's thesis that space and time are mental constructs is correct, then time and space must depend on our way of knowing, which is based on sensation, perception, and conception. This conclusion would be confirmed if we compare our ways of knowing with others' ways of knowing, which employed more or fewer of these faculties. By comparing different grades of consciousness in nature, Ouspensky showed that as the consciousness changes or developed, the sense of space changes and develops. Thus, dimensionality of world depends upon the development of consciousness. Ouspensky established that the space sense increases as the space sense increases, time sense recedes. So mind, which is more aware of space, is less aware of time. An object of higher consciousness that is fourth dimensional or more will have still greater space sense. He will apprehend the world as mere cross-section of his world. Thus, with the change in consciousness, our perception of world changes. Thus, a body which appears to us as moving appears motionless to an object of higher consciousness. Thus, less developed the consciousness, more dynamic the world, more conscious, more developed the consciousness, more static the world. Time is a vague apprehension of which we cannot represent adequately. Thus, for object of higher consciousness, present, past, and future coexist. Here, A is both A and not A. Everything is both A and not A. Everything is all. We perceive the world as three-dimensional, as our consciousness is in its third stage of development. But Ouspensky proposed that a person can transcend three-dimensional space through the faculty of intuition and forces of art, religion and love. He completely refused positivist thought or logic as any assistant to this work. Ouspensky summarized his thesis in the form of table about four forms of manifestations of consciousness at the end of book Tertium Organum. For a man of higher consciousness, laws of phenomenal world are not valid. At higher consciousness, new geometry, that is meta-geometry, new mathematics, that is mathematics of variable and infinite magnitude, and a new body of knowledge, which is a combination of religion, science, philosophy and art, shall prevail. Ouspensky divides reality into ultimate reality and proximate reality. For him, ultimate reality is unknown, but proximate reality, that is the reality of which the given appearance is the appearance, is knowable. Expanding one's space sense, one becomes closer to proximate reality. Thus, Ouspensky recognized space as real and time as illusion. Ouspensky proposed new model of universe wherein he suggests that there are three dimensions of time, three dimensions of space, forming a six-dimensional Euclidean continuum. He argued that time as general time do not exist. Every separate existing system has its own time. Time for him is spiral in nature, where eternity is the curvature of time. This validated the idea of eternal recurrence. Six-dimensional world is illogical in its very nature, and its space can contract and expand. Space can pass into time, and time can pass into space. Three-dimensional space is a function of our senses. Time is the boundary of our senses. Six-dimensional space is the reality, the world as it is. His claim is criticized by Henri Bergson, who was a French philosopher, who stressed the fundamentality of time over space. He refuted the deterministic image of spatial conception of time and find the pure time as the representation of flowing, irreversible succession of states melting into each other and forming indivisible whole. Further, Florensky, in the field of science, he proposed alternative understanding of theory of evolution. Scientific community, considering his ideas illogical, ignored his writings until recently. Now the interest in his work is growing. Scientists, cosmologists are frequently quoting him and are taking insights from his works. According to Robert Simons, scientific theories about birth of universe, unity of laws of physics, interpretation of quantum theory and atomic physics in terms of consciousness and mysticism are very much what the Ouspensky was arguing for. String theory and more recently M theory predicting parallel universes seems to be in the direction of what Ouspensky proposed. Ouspensky draws on ideas from the teachings of Eastern and Western mysticism for inspiration and on examples of both sacred art and scientific thought to frame a vision that transcends materialism and positivist thought. He stressed for convergence of science, philosophy, religion and art for the proper development of civilization. He took insights from the Eastern philosophy and proposed new system of thought in Western idiom. Talking about the Eastern and Western philosophy, Dr. Hume Singh said in Megavision philosophy that both shall unite in future to give singulated jolt for exploring more and more of remotest possibilities. If such centers of unions of Eastern and Western philosophies are to be found, work of Ouspensky shall be prominent center of such union. Thank you.